What you're seeing on your screen is called Codify. So a little bit of background on this. The coders in CBO, they were given access to what's called a APC coder. So it's a very good software, actually. You can basically go ahead and, like, you know, search for codes, look at some, you know, CBT to ICD-9 matching kind of thing. But they made this change to Codify. So Codify basically is like a updated newer software. AAPC talked to a whole bunch of coders, asked what they liked about AAPC coder, what they didn't, and this is kind of what they came up with. The first thing that it's going to ask you is basically if you want to go ahead and start Codify. I'm not quite sure if it's set yet, but you know, there is that little transition period. So they do ask you if you want to go into Codify. Click on it, and this is what the screen that you're going to be taken into. So what you see here is basically just the home screen, right? So the home screen is a whole bunch of things. These are called widgets for Apple folks. That's a new thing for you guys. For Android people, we've had widgets for a while. Subtle dig, sorry. But basically, there's this thing called customize. So for all of you that just want to have everything on the screen, you can do that, right? So the first thing you want to do is customize, and you can select all, right? So select all. You just want everything on your screen. You don't care, right? You just want everything there, and you just, you know, not want to find it. You can save it, and then it gives you everything. So all of these things are called widgets. You can move them around, put them anywhere you want. This is what's called a pin or unpin. You can pin it or unpin it, and it's gone. You can expand and close it if you want, but so these are all widgets. First thing you do is tweak your home page, because obviously, unless you're trying to send a claim out from 2012, you do not need CPT to ICD-9 crosswalk. You can unpin that. There is an NDC lookup tool. I didn't try that yet, but that's a pretty good tool, actually. I think there is one, so you can enter like one of these J codes, and it'll probably show you a list of possible NCDs that crosswalks to it. If you guys customize and you guys select all, you guys can actually like reset it. So if you just want to go right back to the original, basically how it looks. Yeah, okay, so this is the original look of the AAPC Codify. So if you feel like you lost something, you can always reset it and you can kind of find it. Or again, customize, select all, or find what you want. I do recommend having this right here. So if you go into customize, you look at claims edits, make sure this is up. This is called CMS 1500 real-time scrubber. Click that. Don't close out. I've made that mistake a lot of times. Just go ahead and scroll all the way down and save it. Okay, so, and of course you'd probably want to move this somewhere nicer or somewhere higher in the chain. But this is really what I do recommend having on your screen, because you guys will be faced with a lot of CO11 denials, which is diagnosis not related or inconsistent or you know, excludes one. So they did make a few changes. Let me show you. I showed the coders before that what would happen when they use the real-time scrubber. So you're already seeing that there are some errors that's showing up, but what you want to do is make sure you click submit to view the actual thing. I don't know if you can see it, but they did make a slight change to this color. Before, it was way more transparent, actually. It's very close to white. But right now you can at least kind of see it. But if you still can't see it, the only way you can really do it is kind of highlight this portion and then you'll see it. The reason why this is very important, again, this is the fastest way you can find your excludes ones denials, unless you want to, click around in all of these different fields or in your, I believe there is, like if you go into, say a code, you can actually, you're gonna probably have to go into guidelines and look at all of these parts here. Okay, so what you just saw me do is I entered 58558. This is your CPT code section. So there's a lot of things you can do here. So if you're looking up a CPT code, you can like or favorite your CPT code. That'll go into a notepad, and then you can save it as your favorite code. So say you always get like some sort of colectomy code or something, and it's something that you kind of like, I forget about these, I forget some of these things about this code. Maybe I should kind of favorite it and make sure it's on my favorite list so that I can go back to it and then see the terms, you know, all of these guidelines and advice that's, or the lay terms to it, because sometimes we just have a whole bunch of codes we have to go through. We don't want to remember them all. So that's a good way to have it. That's a good thing to do, actually. And then if you look up here, there's a bit more. So there's the notepad. There is the real-time scrubber. So once you're in your code, you can go right into real-time scrubber from here. There's also favorite CCI code, favorite global days calculator. There's a lot of things you can do here. So the one thing that some people did express that they liked about it is that there's a lot of articles. So related articles is basically one of the things that I do like about this software. If you scroll down, there's a related articles portion. AAPC basically bought out SuperCoder, so they do have a big catalog of SuperCoder's library. So they have a lot of it could be old. So if you look here, use 621.0 with 58558. That is, of course, this is ICD-9, but it's still relevant. So you know, you can take a look at it, see what the crosswalk is for you. 621.0 is to ICD-10. You can do that. I know there are some people that I believe, you know, Gordon said it's kind of ugly. Again, what you can do is make sure that you tweak it, so you can make it look as pretty as you want, and then start from there. There's some people that do think that this is one of the best parts about it, because you can really learn more about your code. So there's a lot of questions that coders ask. It's all here.
Mark, I want to ask a question. This
sure.
is Carol.
Yeah.
When it says articles,
yeah,
CMS is now referring to LCDs. They're changing that terminology. They're calling them articles.
Yeah, that's...
So this is not LCD articles. This
no.
is other just
yeah.
regular published news articles
yes.
or something,
yes.
right?
Yes. So
okay.
So there is a difference. So yes, there's LCD, NCD articles. They're making a change to that. That is not related articles. Articles are basically from magazines, from blogs, from AAPC themselves answering a question, or even ACOG answering a question. If you subscribe to the surgery articles, you'll probably get their surgery magazine or online articles access to it. So this is where you're going to find it. LCDs, NCDs is in a different section. It's up here. So you can look at, so there's a compliance tools. So you'll find there's CCI edits, and then there's LCD lookup. Now LCD lookup will take you to your LCDs and stuff like that. Then you can find it. Then you can read up on it, right? So it'll take you there. So it was in AAPC Coder, but now it's basically taking up the entire page. Before, it was real small. Sometimes you could miss it. Related articles was there, but you know, again, it was a very small portion. You couldn't find it, or it wasn't in your vision, so you would just kind of overlook it, right? So what they tried to do was try to put it right in your reading section, so you can find it right away. Aside from that, you know, it's the same thing. You can search all of your codes. You can do all of the same things that APC Coder can do. If you click on coding tools on the top, Kevin showed me this. So there are some shortcuts already built in on from the coding tool section. I do recommend making sure a lot of your favorites or your shortcuts is here, like on your main page. So go ahead and customize it, tweak it, move things around, remove stuff you don't need, put stuff where you want them to be. It's very customizable. It's widget based. It's very simple. So play around with it. If you if you don't like it, let me know. I can't do anything about that, but then we can figure out what we can try. If you do like it, great. Click here to subscribe.